The Jackson County executive says the county is weathering the recession with something rarely seen at the courthouse, cooperation. Mike Sanders says his 2010 budget does not include any more layoffs nor employee furloughs. But as Michael Mahoney reports, things will still be tight. Michael?
Kelly, Mike Sanders today delivered basically his state of the county speech, which amounts to his budget speech. Now, he didn't dwell on the specifics, but he did say that things are not good in Jackson County financially, but he also added they could be worse.
Sanders delivered his speech in what's now friendly territory, chambers of the county legislature, where in the past, county executives and legislators often fought as they governed.
We have recognized that moving forward may only be accomplished or possible if we do so as a community in unison.
The new budget is $352 million. That's about $10 million smaller than last year's general fund. Blame it on the recession. While there are no raises in it, there are no plans for more layoffs, drastic service cuts, or tax increases.
It's never easy to cut budgets. Everybody wants to be Santa Claus. It's even less easy when you have to do it for three straight years.
Budget hawk, legislator Bob Spence.
You know, we don't need a federal bailout in this county like so many governmental entities in this country do. And I give him a lot of credit for that.
Sanders says the regional jail that started this year will continue to save money, and he encouraged other cities to join in. And he praised the circuit court, who took one of the biggest budget hits this year, losing 37 people. The courts and Sanders have butted heads recently.
The 16th Judicial Circuit Court and the county have frankly never had a better working relationship.
It took a lot of planning. We met, you know, all the time, daily, weekly.
Back live here at the courthouse. Now, just a few moments ago, the county adjusted some of the figures they supplied for this report. They say that the budget this year is $25 million smaller than it was last year, not the 10 that they first reported. And also, Sanders is calling for a constitutional convention of sorts. He wants a charter review panel to take a look at the city, at the county charter, and perhaps institute some of the reforms he has in his administration into the law of the county charter. We're live at the courthouse. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Michael. Now, Sanders also defended his plan to try and get Washington to pay all $1 billion of the commuter rail plan he is pushing. He says the region needs it in the 21st century.